Now for this tip, I'm going to use the EZG gate here to isolate the snare from this drum loop, so we're left with just a snare. So if you recall this loop, it sounds like this. Okay, so we've got kick, hat and snare happening there, and we want to get just the snare on its own. Now, of course, using the gate as a normal gate, we can achieve this type of effect. So we can get it to sound tight like this. We can extend the release to get a bit more out of it. Make the attack snappier. So we can get a sharp attack like that, or we can muffle the attack. But we've still got the entire loop dancing by itself. So this is where we can use the sidechain processing here to get the gate to ignore certain things and only open up when it hears the snare. And largely this is going to boil down to the kick drum. If we can get the gate to ignore the kick drum, then it's not going to open up when the kick drum's there. So I'm going to start rolling up this high pass frequency and see how close we can get this. So starting from a reset position now. Okay, now we're still getting a bit of the tail there that I don't like. We can pull the release back a bit and try and hold that off. So the hold makes a different effect again, you can see. Almost like a gated snare sound. Which of course it is. It's a gate on a snare, so it's a gated snare sound. If I shorten that hold, now I'd make up that distance with release instead. Still getting that kick coming in afterwards. But there's the effect. Now that's not bad, but I think we can do better than that. So I've got a second plan here, a plan B. And what I've done in advance is prepared a little tone, a little sine wave tone here that I'm going to use as a key to key our gate to only open up when it hears the sine tone. So therefore the gate's not worried about now what the kick and snare are doing. It's going to open up only when it sees the gate. So let's remove this sidechain, put it back to the default here. And now we're going to start using the key. So I've already sent this tone down the key bus that I'd set up in earlier tutorials. So that's good to go. I'll now set my key input here, so it's going to listen to the key bus. So I've got that there, key, and now we're ready to go. So I want you guys to hear what the tone is actually doing. So I'm going to listen to the key here on module number one. So I'll solo that tone and we can have a listen. Now this is going to be really loud, so I'll turn it down in post-production first so it doesn't blow your ears out, but you'll get to hear what the tone sounds like. Okay, so that's our tone, and just so you see what I've done, I'm going to zoom in to one of them here, and you'll see that I've set that up so that tone begins exactly when the transient of the snare is there, or close enough anyway. Now each of the four of them are going to begin right on the snare that close. Okay, so I'm going to zoom out again. Okay, so we've heard our tone, now let's have a listen to what it does, because we're going to have to make some adjustments. There's a little spoiler for you in advance. Okay, here it goes. Right, now I can adjust things here. Okay, so what we're hearing is not what we want to hear. I'm going to need to move that tone a little bit earlier in time. Now this might be a problem with Pro Tools' delay compensation going down this key bus, but no matter who's causing the problem, we need to be aware of what's going on and how we can deal with it. So what I can hear from that is that the gate is opening, but it's opening way too late. The snare's gone past already. Here it is again. Okay, so what I'm going to do is isolate Pro Tools' timeline and edit selection so I can keep that looping and then I can move this. So there they are there. I'm going to nudge these guys slightly earlier in time while it's playing. And let's see the difference it makes on the gate. I'm moving them 10 milliseconds at a time. You can hear it improving already. Here we go. In fact, I can have it opening well early. It doesn't matter because there's nothing there that's going to get in the way. Okay. Now already that sounds better to me than it did when the gate was dealing with it on its own. Let's now mess with the hold and release controls and see if we can get just the snare. Okay, got a little bit of hi-hat there. There we go. I'm going longer with the hold and shorter with the release to get the sound I want. So again, sounds like an old Phil Collins song with the gated extension. But there it is. So we've gone from a bypassed version of this to this. And it's a bit soft because we've got our output down there. If I put that back up, we've got that against. So there's a tiny bit of hi-hat sneaking in there. So there we have it. That's two different ways we can isolate the snare from the drum loop. So that's our look at McDSP's 6050 Ultimate Channel Strip. I hope you got something out of that and can put this plugin to great use in your productions. See you in my next tutorial.